Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today I'm going to show you how to size the bearings on our 2012 Polaris RZR 900 XP. Pretty simple procedure. Let me go grab a couple of tools and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, as far as the tools go, actually we just need a couple of pages out of the service manual. So let me get those together and we'll get started. All right, guys, step number one in all of this. We need to get all our bearings sized correctly. So there's a chart inside of the Polaris manual. So here's how this works. We're gonna start off with sizing the mains first, but we need to get some information off our block and off our crankshaft. On our block on the end, you're gonna have six numbers. So you need to write those down. And on the crankshaft, because we're putting in a new one, they're gonna be stamped right here. Now this is gonna be a set of letters. Write this down as well. Chances are it ain't gonna be just like mine, because each one of these are unique. That's why Polaris goes through the pain of actually sizing all of this for us. Using a chart, we can determine which bearing goes in. All right, with that information, my particular crankshaft, just on the mains, is gonna be G, B, G, G. All right, off the block, it's all threes. So, using our chart for the main bearings, a G3 is gonna be a yellow. A B3 is gonna be green. Looking at your bearings, this is gonna be yellow. You're gonna have a green one here, and then two more yellows on the end. That will complete just the main bearings. All right, next, we need to size the connector rods. Our old one, the one that we're gonna reuse, has a number on the end cap, which is a 3. All right, our new one has a 2. So, going to the connecting rod chart, a B2 is gonna be a blue bearing. A B3 is gonna be a green bearing. Go ahead and get our base gasket in place before we put the pistons and the cylinders over there. Need to get one half of the bearing on each one. And hopefully you've been keeping this organized. I tend to lay things out on the table to where they swing over to where they should go. All right, just a little dab of oil in here. And let's go ahead and set it on the block. All right, so this is gonna be surfaces 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we want to go ahead and get the bearings in for 1, 3, 5, and 6. That's going to be our mains. Yellow, green, yellow, yellow. All right, right there, you can see just a little bit of yellow. So that's what we want. This one should be green. Then two more yellows. All right, next, I'm going to go ahead and dab each one of those bearings with a little bit of oil. Now, we can go ahead and lay the crank in. Well, that looked pretty good to me. So, if you need any of the parts or tools that we use to get this done, come see us at Partzilla.com. We can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, didn't really see what I was doing or didn't understand it, leave me a question in the section below and I'll do my best to answer it. And until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.